Hello students, again I welcome you in the very next video of chapter number 1, that is index number. Students, in our previous video what we have seen the second method. In that method what we have seen, the conversion of fixed base index number to change base index number, and it was having two categories, that the base year is mentioned in the question or not, and the base year is mentioned in the question or not. What we have to do, we have already done in the previous video. Students, in this video what we are going to read, we are going to understand the conversion of change base index number to fixed base index number. So for that, I am taking the fourth question of your exercise, that is exercise 1.2. I am taking the very fourth number question from your textbook. So if you look the question, so in question what is given? In question that is given that you have to convert change base index number to the fixed base index number. Right, student? And for the conversion, change base to the fixed base, you have the formula. Let's see the formula. It's very easy. The formula is change base index number of current year, the year which is going on, that is the current year, multiplied by fixed base index number of preceding year, okay, and it will be divided by 100. Means it is the product of change base index number of current year multiplied by product of fixed base index number of preceding year, and it is divided by 100. So that is the formula, and let's solve it, okay. So as you can see in the screen, in the board, like the year is given to you, that is 2010, 2011, 2012, 13, 14 and 15 respectively. Similarly, the change base index number is given below, that is 110, 112, 109, 108, 105 and 111, that is 111. Let's move for the solution one. Students, as it is given that change base index number of current year, so for the year 2010, the change base index number for the current year will be 110. So you will write down 110 multiplied by the fixed base index number of preceding year. As you can see, student, in this question we have not mentioned the fixed base of the preceding year. So student, for that purpose what you will use 100. You will use 100 in all the time. You have to remember one point. The point is, whenever it is asked you to solve, to convert change base index number to fixed base index number, for the very first year, student, you will use 100 as fixed base index number of preceding year. So that's why I have written 100 over here. And it will be same in all the question, student. Okay? So that is 110, changes index number for the current year multiplied by 100, that is the fixed base index number for the preceding year, and it is divided by 100. So if you will going to solve this, 100 and 100 going to be cancelled, so your answer is 110, student. Okay, I hope you are getting. Again I am explaining you, for the very first year, that is 2010, you will use the change base index number for the current year, which is already mentioned in the question, and multiplied by fixed base index number of preceding year, which is not mentioned in question. So for that purpose, you will use 100 in all the questions. Whenever they will ask you to convert changes to fixed base, for the very first year, you will use 100, student. Okay? Moving to the second year, that is 2011. So for 2011, student, the change base index number for the current year is 112 multiplied by fixed base index number for the preceding year. So the preceding year is 110, student. Fixed base index number of the preceding year. So preceding year of 112 is 110. So multiply 110 and divide by 100. Okay? You will get the answer. You need to simplify and you will get the answer. Moving to the third year, that is again fixed base of the current year multiply, so changes of the current year multiply fixed base of preceding year. So you are getting answer over here, right, student? So you need to put this value over here and you have to divide it by 100. Moving to the next, year student, that is for the 2013. Change year will be 108 multiplied by the preceding. Preceding will be this one. Divided by 100, you will get the answer. Moving to the next one for 2005 student again. 105 multiplied by the preceding of the fixed year. So preceding will be this one. So and it will be divided by 100, you will get the answer again over here. The last, that is 111. So current year will be 111 multiplied by the fixed of the preceding. It will be this one divided by the 100, and again you will get answer over here. So student, you can calculate the thing and let's see you are getting the correct answer or not. So student, I think you are getting this answer over here. Let me explain you again. The very first year will be 110 multiplied by 100 upon 100. You will get 110 student. Okay, because I told you for the fixed base index number of the preceding year, you will take 100 all the time. So 100 and 100 going to be cancelled over here, so you will get 110. For the second year student, the second year, the change base for the current year, that is 112 multiplied by fixed base of preceding year. So the preceding year is 110, so I am mentioning 110 over here, divided by 100, you will get the solution 123.30. Again, for the year 2012, the change base index number for current year is 109 multiplied by fixed base of the preceding. So for this year, preceding will be this one student. So you are getting 134.29. Again, for the year 2013, current year is 108 multiplied by the preceding one. So preceding for 2008 will be 134.29, and divided by 100 you will get 145.03. Moving to the 2014 year, so current year value for the change base is 105. I've written 105 over here student, multiplied by the preceding year. So the preceding for this one is this 145.03. You have to divide by 100, you will get 152.28. And for the last year, that is 2015, the current year, the change base of current year will be 111, and the fixed base for the preceding will be 152.28, and divided by 100 you will get 169.03. So students, this will be the all solution, and it is very easy, I hope, and this will be asked in 3 marks student. So you need to practice very hard, and for your homework, let me tell you, you need to practice question number 1 of the same exercise 1.2, as well as the illustration part which is mentioned, the conversion of changes index number 2 fixed base index number student. Till then, thank you.